The year is 2009, and the 19-year-old country singer Taylor Swift has just won the award for Best Music Video on the VMA Gala. A nervous Swift only comes halfway through her speech before a drunk Kanye West takes the microphone from her. The words soon to come out from his mouth would change his career forever.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish. But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time.
After this incident, all of America hated the 32-year-old rapper, and Kanye's career appeared to be over. Jay found himself being portrayed as a villain, which led to him getting depressed, and he directly took a plane to Japan to get away from the press and the paparazzi for a while. Or maybe forever. Never See Me Again is the name of a Kanye track leaked 1 month before the release of his masterpiece My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. The song is believed to have been recorded shortly after the VMA incident, when Kanye was in a deep depression, and rumors says that this track was meant to be the last thing we were supposed to hear from KanYE Omari West before he retired or even took his own life. Although the song is far from finished, it is a terrifying listen, with lyrics seeming to be a draft to a suicide note. Kanye spends 9 minutes expressing his deep thoughts and tells the listener how it will be a long time before we'll ever see him again.
Hey motherfuckers, it'll be a long time before you ever see me again.
The what seems to be a happy and catchy piano riff may also have a darker meaning. The instrumental is rumored to either be sampled or greatly inspired by the Japanese singer Yukiko Okada's song Futari Dake no Ceremony. Yukiko Okada's story is terrifying, and it's easy to draw parallels between her and Kanye's situation. Yukiko was a popular singer in Japan in the 80s and seemed to have a bright future ahead of her. But after being rejected by the actor Toru Minegishi, Yukiko jumped from a building to end the pain she felt. Yukiko had reportedly left a amount of suicide notes before her tragic ending, one of them saying, "All I wanted was to see him again," a line that eerie matches the title of Kanye's song. And if we put the pieces together, you notice that the theories are very likely correct. Kanye was depressed, went to Japan, probably found out about Yukiko while there, and used one of her songs as a hint about what he was about to do. Everything could also really just be made up, and maybe it was just a way for Kanye to write his feelings off him. But there's even more to indicate that the theories surrounding the song are true. On the song Power, released only a few months after Never See Me Again leaked, the lyrics say the same thing. Listen to how the word "so exciting" slowly fades into the word "suicide." Later on in the track, Kanye also frightfully says, "The lyrics for this song strongly suggest that the Never See Me Again theories are true." Thankfully, the story ended happily, and Kanye still walks among us and has since created beautiful art. If you have problems with your mental health, I strongly suggest that you seek help and try to talk to someone. Everybody on this planet has their own struggles, and no one is alone. No one should ever give up. Thank you for watching.